Welcome to The Resistance, Player 2's full playthrough series dedicated to the Resistance franchise as developed by Insomniac Games. That means Resistance Fall of Man, Resistance 2, and Resistance 3. My name is Paul James, and welcome to part 4 of Resistance 3. So, let's get back into it. We're up to Graterford now. You might recall from the ending of that last episode that we're basically just getting tossed into an arena here. Humans got involved, so we're actually having some encounters with not Chimera, but human enemies. And that was kind of a cool twist that was obviously something I played when I initially played Resistance 3 back in 2011 or whatever it was. But I actually had completely forgotten about that aspect, so it was a really cool little surprise. So, I'll wait for this load screen. Here we go. Dealing with a ton of grims.
These grims aren't hungry enough. More grims! Throw in a few leeches, too.
Oh. What do we got? Where are we? Come on. Oh, some health. GTA Trevor's in this piece. They certainly look the part anyway.
Joseph. Joseph. That's your name, isn't it? I found this book among Dr. Malikov's things. He was a brilliant man. My name is Herbert Sawicki. I've been Mick's lackey for over 3 years. I'm tired of being a victim. No more. I have a plan to escape. But we need to move quickly. You see that drone up there? There are 4 of them around the prison. You need to disable them. Here, I made something that should keep you safe. You can pull the trigger to fire quickly, or hold it down to build up pressure for a more powerful shot. Take the radio too. I'll get the door.
New weapon. The mutator. Biological weapon, blah blah blah. Press and hold R1 to charge. Fires infectious biological projectiles.
Please, please.
What the fuck was that?
Quit back. I ain't gonna let you out.
Die. I should have warned you. That weapon tends to have some rather unpredictable results.
All right. Low ammo. What I'd like is for some ammo.
With an aerosol can hooked up to the mutator, you can disperse a cloud into a group.
I mean, that's great, but again, I still don't have much to work with ammo-wise. Be overrun by Chimera. Hardly seems like a great idea. But we do what we gotta do.
Nick asked me to make some repairs to the remote access transistors.
Nick didn't say nothing to me about no transistors need repair.
Oh, sure.
Try and be kind of conservative with the ammo. I don't want to be spraying and praying too much with this thing, given
we were almost compromised. I should be more careful.
Given I don't have a lot to
I can
work
open
with.
Up the security doors from these stations. Follow me. I'll open up the showers wing for you. This used to be the central control hub for the whole prison. Now they use it for entertainment of a sort.
There he is.
They call themselves wardens. They used to be prisoners here, but now they live on the other side of the bars. There's no explanation for their behavior. They're just drunk with power. Or fear. Or both. Let's see here. The drone should be up on a catwalk at the far end of the room.
Yep,
but you'll have to go through the showers to get there. My apologies.
Righto. Nothing down there. Gotcha. Now, I won't lie, I'm tempted by the fact that it looks like there's a trophy attached to more of those melee kills. Swapped over to a shotgun. They're just spraying and praying at the moment. They have no idea where I am. I mean, that guy does now. Reloading, I'd be able to conserve that round. Oh. These guys should well and truly know by now, after that train sequence, how dangerous I am with a carbine in hand. So we've got a couple grenades as well, which is something to keep in mind, specifically an air fuel one, which... What happened there? Oh, they've killed the lights. Alright.
Uh-oh.
Let's go to the shop.
What was that? I got it, Joe. It's a blown fuse in the main breaker. I can fix it from here. Hold on. Opening doors for cell block B. Door's not working. Maybe it's off the grid. Try forcing it.
Done.
Here's the drone ahead. There's a security gate in the way. You'll have to go down to the first floor through the utility room.
Hell of a fight tonight.
Yeah.
Music's changed, which, you know, makes me think they know where I am. They know where I am. Gotcha. Nothing better than in the shooter of some sort, whether it's a first person, third person, whatever, shooting a guy just as they're about to launch a grenade, they drop it and take themselves out in the process. It's a really, really satisfying feeling. Don't see anyone just yet. Is that someone up the top? Oh, there we are. Let it to mom. Like for. Alright, let's swap it back over the carbine. Infected with the Chimeran virus, and I'm something of a monster. Certainly, if nothing else, capable of kicking your pathetic asses. Oh, no idea. Pop. Again, we're being offered snipers here, so there's probably some purged guys that I want to be taking out. Wow. That's a hell of a lot of... Ooh. Targets.
Look, the Chimera are starting to investigate. Our plan is working. We just have one more drone to disable, then this place will be swarming with them. Get to the cafeteria on the lower level. I'll meet you in the kitchen.
Dinner's over, boys. We need all hands on deck. Herbert and his new friend Joe think they're gonna bring us down. Let's show them what happens when you fuck with the wardens.
They are quite distracted.
The wardens are done with dinner. Now's our chance to get into the cafeteria and destroy the wooden drone.
Not hanging in there by all that much.
Get to the cafeteria, Joseph. They're close to freedom.
Don't worry about those drones. The one we want is in the cafeteria.
Alright. Just need a bit of health.
Maybe this one. Get rid of the rest of the kitchen crew. I'm gonna use the maintenance tunnel to go around. I'll meet you in the kitchen.
Go with something slow like that. Because I can't really see where I'm being shot from at the moment.
Wait a minute. There's something wrong with this drone.
You looking for this? All these years. You think you can survive outside these walls, huh?
you wouldn't last a week.
One last wave, I guess.
Oh no! You're trapped! This door is locked! If you give me a couple of minutes, I think I can rewire it. But you won't like where it leads to.
Oh, I mean, that's a...
Look around this hell path.
To land one of these bad boys, not a bad get at this point. Wow. Jeez, I don't know that I'm gonna survive this one. One unit of basically borderline one unit of health left.
If you're running low,
it's been a long while since I've died in Resistance 3. Which is actually a far cry from the other games where I was getting hammered fairly regularly.
Oh,
until
no.
Kind of the back end of Resistance 2.
This door is locked. Give me a couple of minutes. Keep my feet wired. But you won't like where it leads to. Door's still stuck. Just a little longer.
Maybe the carbine.
Don't let him hunker down. Flank him.
Prisoners free.
Whatever, it'll do. But I'd imagine this is where the Chimera come back into it again, because
I don't want the sledgehammer yet. Oh, maybe I do. Because obviously... Oh no, we've still got this one last one to take out. In the end, they skimmed it off me first. Still a couple of leeches around.
So you think he's dead?
He jumped into the pit, man, if he ain't dead yet. He will be soon.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, I bet if we find Herbert before anybody else, they will give us something nice.
Yeah, let's check the motor pool.
I'll just let them come to me. No. They're not, so I guess I go for them. Pieces of shit can keep away from me. Up the ladder.
Did you see the teams in Solok, eh?
Yup. Death squads are coming our way, I bet.
Shit. Should we run?
Run? Where to?
Story of Mick and Dick.
Damn right you don't know. This here's our home. We defend it.
So we're slowly getting our entire arsenal back. Though I don't know if the cryo gun's necessarily the sort of one that I want right now. Oh, maybe it is. Ooh, yeah it is.
switch it up because we are out of ammo. Firstly, just change the ROS. Definitely wasn't my intent. I went the ROS more and whatnot before, but we can take a breath. There's some health. Alright, where to from here?
I am honored to have Dr. Malakoff's journal and a bit intimidated. It will take time to wrap my head around all of this data. However, one event early in his notes seems significant. He writes that he interviewed Joseph Capelli after he killed Nathan Hale. Joseph said Hale uttered a mysterious phrase when the wormhole first appeared in the sky. Hale said, "Can you hear them? It's beautiful."
Yeah. The closing moments of Resistance 2 is basically what's being discussed there. I'm not heading back out there, so where's... Oh, they just want me to shoot.
Dropship in the motor pool. Get some rockets out there and bring it down.
Our plan is working. The Chimera are starting to...
Alright, let's go to
marksman. I'll free the rest of the prisoners while the wardens deal with the Chimera.
Don't worry, boys. We'll be fine as soon as we kill these Chimera. I still got a drone in here.
Can't let Nick escape with that last drone.
Oh.
Let's make sure he can never hurt anyone else ever again.
So we've got some ammo. We've got a wildfire, which is great news. But I don't see anyone. Which in and of itself is a little disconcerting. But they're probably just out of my line of sight.
I see. find you.
Alright, let's... Oh, is that someone over there at that light? These good headshots. And now we've actually got some Chimera hybrids to contend with as well. That they know where I am just yet, so I'll happily leave it that way for a little while and just slowly pick some people up like I have been, get some of those stealth kills, maybe make a run on that trophy at the same time. Whoa. Oh, it's the dropship that's shooting at me. Oh, but I got a wildfire. So let's just go back to Marksman. Stumbled straight into where I was supposed to go.
You might be wondering why I've been helping Mick for so long. Well, I'm not proud of it. There is blood on my hands, but we all do what we have to in order to survive.
All right. Yeah, all right, that was bad to happen.
Hale, aren't you? They said you got kicked out of the circle. There ain't many of us left. Men like us, we're born to fight. You want this?
Come on.
managed to free some of the others, but we gotta move. I didn't think I'd ever get out of there alive. If there's ever anything I can do to repay you.
Take care of each other.
Capelli's such a better character than what he was in Resistance 2. Obviously he was a secondary character there, but as lead protagonist he's, and with you know the time that's passed and what, he's actually a little more rounded, there's a bit more depth. All the things you want from a good protagonist. Now, New York is our final chapter, or our final act of Resistance 3. So we're going to leave things right here. Once we get through this cutscene, we'll do the usual wrap-up. But remember, while this scene's playing out, remember we are playing this, because I adore the Resistance franchise and I want to acknowledge how awesome it is and what Insomniac's done. But B, the reality is, we're about to enter a new console generation. Xbox is launching Halo. PlayStation's been rightly or wrongly accused of having a very one-dimensional portfolio of titles over the course of this last generation. The third-person action game, God of War, Last of Us, Uncharted. They're, as brilliant as they might be, Horizon Zero Dawn, they're all the same sort of game at their core. And I think Resistance, firstly to go head-to-head with Halo, as it did, you know, years ago, is the perfect franchise to assume that mantle and take on that role. So we're going to celebrate, acknowledge it, and cross our little fingers and hope that we see more of it.
This thing's working. My name is Joe Capelli. This message is from my wife, Susan. I miss you. I made it. I'm in New York, close to the tower, I think. If I can make it there alive, I'll try and destroy it. But Malakoff is dead. If he were here, I might have a chance. Like you said, I tried my best. I love you. Tell Jack I loved him.
One last little swig and then we'll get going.
So we'll get through this cutscene. There we go. So that is where we're going to wrap up this entry of the Resistance. So we're now in New York. That sets up the final act of this game. If you've enjoyed this episode, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. All the buttons down below. Hit the notification bell. That way you're alerted to every new video at the moment it goes live on the channel. That includes Patch, The Insider, more Player 2 plays like this, Game Review, Game School, and a whole bunch more. There's some awesome stuff there that can only be found on this channel, so please subscribe and go and check it out. Visit the website player2.net.au where you'll find reviews, previews, opinion pieces, news, features, links to the podcast series Patched, which also has an audio form, the Player 2 Pixelcast, and Dev Diary, where there's been some awesome guests over the recent weeks and months, and there's some more really talented developers coming on the show over the course of the coming weeks and months. So please subscribe, 5-star reviews, helps with exposure, and go and check all of those out. We are also on Patreon, patreon.com/player2au, kicking a few bucks. At the lower tiers, you get early access episodes. At the higher tiers, monthly episode exclusives. Finally, there's Twitter. You can find me at Paul James Games, the website you find at player2au. And until next time, welcome to the Resistance.